Welcome back to The Rhode Show. Well, if you're looking for love this Valentine's Day, and who isn't really, there may be some simple things you can do, like improving your online dating profile to find the one. Here now to share some tips to ensure a great dating experience using the World Wide Web is Dr. Ian Smith of The Doctors. Good morning, Dr. Smith. Your first tip you have for us today is to face the facts. Elaborate a little more on that one for us.
Good morning, Brendan. Thanks for having me. You know, yeah, you got to face the facts. You know, the idea that your romantic comedy moment is going to happen where you're in the grocery store and all of a sudden you meet your love interest, that's not reality. That's Hollywood. You got to be proactive. Go online and look for a place that's going to allow you to shine, but also meet some very interesting people. So be proactive and go online right from the beginning.
And now, how can we go about creating, you know, a winning profile? What are the steps we can take to do that?
Well, you know, it's interesting. You know, you want to create a profile. It's like a digital ad for yourself. It's a resume. And you want to make sure that you are highlighting yourself. You know, you don't want to be negative. You want to be positive. Talk about things that you like, not things that you don't like. But also include a full photograph of yourself, a full body photograph. We saw studies that show that people have a full photograph have 203% more messages than those who just do a headshot. So really go out there and think about how you can best position yourself so others will be attracted and interested in you.
Sure, and I would think, too, it's all about a positive attitude as well. I mean, certainly that's the case when you're meeting people in person, but online as well, I would think you want to have the right attitude about this entire thing.
100%. You know, I work with a company called Zeusk.com, an online dating company. You know, they're the number one online dating app, mobile dating app. But they use something called smart technology, which is that they are able to look at your preferences and track you and match you better. It's almost like Amazon. When you make purchases at Amazon, after a while, they get to know your spending behavior and they make suggestions. Well, same thing with Zeusk. I mean, you want to be in line with a company that's going to actually give you the best match possible, that's going to give you the greatest chance of success. And what that means is being smart about it. It's not just filling out surveys or quizzes. Those don't work. People are not really honest. But you want to make sure that there's technology and algorithms involved that make a lot of sense.
Now, when it comes to choosing the right person to date, you say to choose wisely. Tell us a little bit more about this. It's good advice.
Yeah, well, because not everyone's a match. I mean, people look good on paper, but that doesn't mean they're the right match for you. You really want to spend some time really talking to this person, typically online. You don't want to give away too much information, where you live, where you work. So really take your time and go through your criteria. I mean, really hold yourself to the criteria. Not too many, by the way, because then you won't find anyone, but really have some essential things that you're looking for in a mate. And then really decide if this is the person I want to meet. And then, of course, do that in an open place where it's very busy, very active, and typically during the day.
And what's the best way someone can get started if they're like on the fence about doing this? How should they get going in starting an online dating profile?
The first thing is to think about who you're looking for. I mean, that sounds really simple, but people often don't do that. Think about what you're really looking for. Think about who you are and how you can present yourself in your best light, and then sign up. For example, at Zeusk.com, you can create your profile for free and then really go into it. I mean, there's such a steep learning curve, Brendan, that once you start and become familiar, it becomes old hat. And 25%, by the way, of marriages or long-time relationships have been found online. So it really is, online dating really is where it is now, and people just need to be smart about it to find their success.
That's great advice. Thank you so much, Dr. Smith. I am mentally preparing my online dating profile as we speak. If you missed any if you missed any of these tips, don't worry. We're going to post them on our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com. Happy Valentine's Day.